Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to today's video. Now in this video I want to show you some accessories you might want to consider if you have the FZ80 or 82 camera. A couple of enhancements you can make to the camera to make it more user friendly. You may find that when you're using the EVF or the eye level viewfinder, you find that the focus goes out of adjustment very, very quickly. There's a little adjustment knob here on the side of the EVF, which allows you to change the diopter strength to match your own eyesight. But you'll find, because of the flimsiness of this mechanical device, it goes out of focus very quickly. So one of the fixes I got for that is to actually put some sellotape over there, or some electrical insulation tape, gaffer tape, whatever, to stop this wheel rotating. So the idea is that you will turn on the camera, you'll set the EVF focus position, so you got it right, so you're looking at the icons around the screen to make sure that you've got perfect focus. Then take a little bit of black adhesive tape or sellotape, or you could even use something modeling clay or blue tack, even hot glue. Just put a little bit of hot glue just on the back end of that wheel to stop it moving. So you just put that over the wheel and secure it to the EVF. When you've done that, you'll find that you can move the camera, you can jump it and move it around, and you'll find that that focus position doesn't change from shot to shot or day to day, which you will normally do with the current setup. The second modification I want to show you is the actual EVF itself. Now, it's on your plastic housing, and if you've got this up to your eye for any period of time, say you're shooting video, you'll find that your eyebrow starts to hurt after a while. So I came up with this modification a few years ago, and it is the fixing of the Nikon DK20 eye cup to the EVF. Now this you can do using double-sided tape if you just want to make it a temporary fixture, or you can use hot glue so you can actually remove it at a later date, or you can use a more permanent fixture. Now it depends how rough you are, if you like, with the camera. If you've got this on a strap around your neck, then the EVF is going to be the thing that's rubbing against your body, so this needs to be firmly attached. If you're just using this out of your camera bag, then you can get away with a much lighter fixing. Now I want to make mine almost a permanent installation, so I'm going to bond this quite securely to the EVF. There is a plastic inner liner to the outside rubber, so it's that plastic that we're going to bond to the plastic of the EVF. Now to do that, you can use the cyanacrylic super glue type glues, but here I've got what's called the Fantastic Elastic. It's a flexible glue, so it does have a strong bond, but it just allows a little bit of movement in the actual joint itself. So what I'm going to do is apply a little bit of the glue to both the three sides of the EVF, so we're going to use the side, top and other side. No need to go across the bottom because that doesn't impact anything on the EVF here itself. So a little bit of glue to the surround of this device, just around the plastic on the three sides. We've got an even coat around the frame, and I'll do the same with the EVF of the camera. So just going to put a thin coating of this glue around the EVF like that. Now this particular glue remains flexible for 5 minutes, so that does give you a little bit of time to get the alignment. So you're just going to align it physically over the aperture. It's quite a large aperture in this DK20, as you can see, so it's quite easy to get the alignment correct. So just eyeballing the viewfinder, and I can just check that we're in the center and that looks good. Now the actual eye piece itself of the camera has a slight curve to it, so if you wanted to, you could put a weight on there just to hold that in place while it sets, but generally you'll find that the camera will bond quite nicely I've done this several times, trying out different eye cups, but the DK20 is the one that matches the format of the EVF of the FZ80-82, and it looks quite a nice little fixture once you've got it in place. So that's the eye cup modification. Again, I'll put links in the video description below to where you can purchase this. I got these from Amazon. So I'll put the link in the video description below. It will be an affiliate link, obviously. I do get a slight commission if you do purchase it from Amazon, but it doesn't impact the cost to you. Now, the next option is the plate that I fixed to the bottom of the camera, which shifts the mounting point to the central point of the lens. Normally it's off to one side, so if you want to put this on a panorama nodal, then you'll find that the camera isn't in the center. The plate I've designed, I'll put dimensions to it in the FZ80-82 page of my photographic blog, and again I'll put a link to that in the video description below. It does allow you to still open the battery compartment to get out the battery or the SD card, so it's still accommodating that way. On the right hand side here, you notice we've got a countersink screw, which is 1/4-20, and that is fixing the plate to the bottom of the camera. On the center line of the lens axis, we've got our 1/4-20 threaded hole, which is to allow you to use your quick release plates or mount this to your tripod. On the other side of the plate is a small rubber disc, which then stops this rotating on the bottom of the camera. I did make another plate which I intended to put on my photographic blog website under the store page, but I was never happy with the finish that I could achieve. It's basically an aluminium plate with the hole, instead of just drilled and 1/4-20 threaded hole, I put an insert in there to protect the threads of the device. So that was what I was going to do. I'll put a link to that. You can have a look at it on my website. So while that EVF is bonding, I want to show you a lens hood. Now, I'm a great believer in fitting a lens hood to these cameras in preference to doing anything like a UV filter or a skylight filter. Modern lenses don't need that sort of protection from UV. The glass elements themselves and the Bayer filter will filter out that UV anyway. If you wanted to add extra protection, then go for the best filter you can afford rather than the cheaper ones, or you will get ghosting, flaring, and in some cases a loss of resolution. So I tend not to use any filters at all on the camera unless I purposely want to put a circular polarizing filter or neutral density, for example. So this is a lens head. It's a 55mm thread to match the lens thread, and it's a wide angle model. I'll put links to this again in the video description below. So this will just screw into the lens like so, and that provides adequate shading even at the 20mm position when you're using the 4:3 setting, so you don't get any vignette. A nice feature about this particular lens hood is the fact that it's threaded and it will take a 77mm filter. So if you wanted to fit a filter without having to take the lens hood off, you can fit the 77mm filter into the lens hood, and I use that quite often if I want to use neutral density with the camera. So that's a useful addition. Again, links to that in the video description below. Now, the other modification I want to show you is the way that you would fit the dummy battery box if you wanted to use this camera for an extended period of time. So this is the dummy battery box. It's the DC coupler model DCC6. So it's the replacement for the battery. So again, you just remove the battery. On the side of the camera housing is a little plastic plug which you just remove to one side. Insert the dummy battery as you would a battery. Click that in place, bring the cable out to the side, close the battery compartment door, and now you can power this from your power bank with a step-up module. I've got a lithium-ion battery pack here which is 8.4 volts. So that would plug into this device. I can plug that into the dummy battery box, and then I've got an inline battery monitor so I can actually tell what the voltage output from this is, and there's more information on my blog about these devices. So I'm just going to plug that into there. It shows me that the battery output is 7.83, So it's almost fully charged. And then this just connects to the camera. And you notice the camera's now come back up. If I change back over to the LCD, you can see an image coming from the camera. So we've now powered the camera from a lithium ion power bank, which will last quite a few hours rather than just the 1200 milliamp hours of these small batteries. So get an extended runtime if you're using it for time-lapse photography or you're using it for video. So if you wanted to look at that, that's the DC-C6 coupler, and then you use a 8.4 volt lithium ion power bank, something like a cycle headlamp, or use the USB power bank with a step up DC-DC converter, which goes from 5 volts to 8.4. So those are the modifications I wanted to bring to your attention for the FZ80. Hope you found that useful. Again, if you're a new viewer to the channel and liking what you see, please do hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and then you'll be advised when I upload new videos to the channel. Also, check out my photographic blog if you've not seen it. There will be a link in the video description below. There's lots more information on all Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras and on the Canon mirrorless series as well. So check that out if you've not already done so. So as usual, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in my next video. Goodbye for now.